the first part of the question, you see, Vatican II opened up a Pandora's box. Gaudium expressed number 53, I think. The word culture was given a new meaning. Culture means anything that we do to develop our life. And then that biological evidence was translated by the FABC bishops in 1974 in Taipei, 4 years after the birth of FABC. They want a church that is indigenous, enculturated, and in dialogue. And they discovered that this is the best way to do mission and to be church. That gave them the idea that a new Pentecost, a new beginning, is going to take place in Asia. Your second question is, how do the bishops respond to that? I guess in their own way, they are responding to that. So I would say, I'm not a bishop, ask the bishops. Ask Bishop Romolo in a ticket. I last one, as I said, Romulo is famous only in Salvador. But there is a good sign that our church is slowly, festina lente, as Monsignor said, very slowly responding to that. Now, migration is changing the social, cultural, religious landscape of the Philippines. Are we ready for that? And if we are ready for that, how can we prepare our people? There's the need for more seminars, workshops, retreats, on mission, on dialogue, on evangelization. Thank you.
Thank you. I just want to make a comment on that. Never forget that when it comes to the Holy Spirit, the Book of Pentecost, our tactual is come Holy Spirit. We are still only begging Him to come. Vatican II already was prognosticated as the new Pentecost. FABC simply borrowed the idea. And as we noted earlier, it will take 100 years before Vatican II really bear pulling the fruits. And FABC, that's you have to be aware of the mechanics that you have. FABC has been characterized by having experts meeting regularly. They're very productive precisely because they make use of the services of first-class theologians. But a problem with the FABC is your own work, how to share it sa ibaba. Not all bishops are aware of what FABC is doing because that will still be coursed through the particular bishops' conferences, and the bishops' conferences will have its own dynamics on whether what they receive by way of documentation will, of course, there will be bibliography, you have the books. And by the way, FABC has a resource book on dialogue. It has all the documents from Vatican II up to the latest, and they are all ready for you. I forgot to mention that, whether that can be made available to every catechetical director. All the pertinent citations on the need and the ways of dialogue. So, as anything with the church, what transpires somewhere on the top is not necessarily available at the bottom. And this is proven by this group itself, that these things have been around. The first international mission congress in the Philippines, okay, you know, 1979, I was a participant and I was group head. And some of the ideas, 79, are still only in the books. And they have not really been utilized on the ground. That's how slowly we move. And that's why it is very important, an institute like this, for you. But then, how do you share it down the line in the various dioceses? Then, how is it shared sa parokya level? Iba pa yung sa social media, iba pa yung sa textbooks, iba pa yung sa mass media, at iba pa ngayon yung direct first-hand contact people with the theatrical church in terms of the priests giving talks and homilies. Yun ang proseso na doesn't make it any easier, but as I said, always we pray ardently, Veni Creator Spiritus, come Holy Spirit, we need your fire. Amen.
Thank you, Monsignor Father. We end this morning session. Time check, it is 12:13 in the afternoon. The bell will ring at 2 o'clock. Would that be okay? And we gather at around 2:15 for updates on CPCP ECHE as well as the International Eucharistic Congress in Cebu. Possibly Father Zamora of the Archdiocese who can help us, especially the accommodations and online registration for the IEC 2016. After that would be some inputs on the pastoral exposure, which will transpire tomorrow and Thursday. Thank you, kindly stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Regina Celi, Laetare, Alleluia. We are Quemeruis de Portare, Alleluia. Resurrexit, Sicut Dixit, Alleluia. Ora pro nobis Deum, Alleluia. Rejoice and be glad, the Virgin Mary. Pray, O God, by the light of the Holy Spirit, to instruct the hearts of your faithful, grant the beseeching that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, His Mother, we may attain the joys of everlasting life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good noon, everyone.